In het bijzonder fraaie Crimson Peak speelt Tom Hiddleston een Britse edelman die klem komt te zitten tussen zijn dominante zus en zijn nieuwe liefje uit Amerika.
Goodness, how many rooms are there?
I don't know. Would you like to count them? What do you think? Does it look the part?
It does. Although it's even colder inside than out.
I know, it's a disgrace. We try to maintain the house as best we can, but with the cold and the rain, it's impossible to stop the damp and erosion. And with the mines right below, well, the wood is rotting and the house is sinking.
Guillermo gave you a 10-page backstory on your character. Does that help?
Very much so, yes. It helps create dimension in the character. It means that the character exists in an imaginative world outside the screenplay. And so there are links between what a character says and does with a backstory, with a past. There were things he gave to me and there were things he gave to Jessica Chastain, who's playing my sister, that were the same. And it's his way of saying, this is your childhood. And you're allowed to respond differently to those events, but this is what happened. And it actually creates an extraordinary integrity to the work, I find.
And he wanted you to keep it a secret to the other characters?
Some things, not everything.
And did you?
Yes, I did. There are some things that he instructed Jessica and myself to keep secret from Mia, and some things he instructed me to keep secret from Jessica, which I did.
And was it difficult?
No. It just comes out. It comes out in the film that eventually those secrets, the fact that we played those secrets and kept those secrets close, you can see those dynamics working in the film, I think.
So you didn't have to see or hear her secrets afterwards? You already saw them while playing?
No, I think there are things I don't know about Jessica's character which I'll never know.
You won't ask?
I may try.
She might answer.
She might, yeah. It's good for actors to have secrets, I think. I think it's important.
Why?
Because it keeps the work mysterious. I think there's an element of mystery in all of our lives. I think it means there's always an interior life. You know, the camera sees this, but it sees into your eyes, but it sees there's something going on behind your eyes, and maybe not. And it's good if, as an actor, I know what that is, and the audience don't.
She knows who I am, and she wants me to leave.
Nonsense, my dear. You're not going anywhere. You had a bad dream. You were sleepwalking.
No. I'm afraid I shall go mad if I stay.
My darling, you're imagining things. Tomorrow, why don't we go out to the post office? I think some fresh air would do you good.
No. I have to leave. I have to get away from here.
Edith, this is your home now. You have nowhere else to go.
The backstory is part of preparing for a role. Is preparation the best part of being an actor?
Preparation, I personally find fascinating. I've always enjoyed the intellectual research. And also it feels in a way sometimes like the freest aspect of it. Because the only limits you have are the limits of your own imagination.
So if preparation is a very fascinating part, what is the best part of being an actor?
I think the best part of being an actor, for me, is sharing my belief that we contain multitudes. I think identity is fluid, and I think we are all capable of so many possibilities. We have many selves, and I am allowed professionally to invest myself in the range of what it means to be alive, if that makes sense. So,
but does that mean that acting is sort of discovering yourself?
It's not discovering myself, it's discovering the capacity of other lives, if you see what I'm saying. So you get to live lots of different lives in a very small way. Acting is the privilege of living in the shoes of someone else for a short time.